cooperation between the two countries. The current visit by Prime Minister Narendra Modi was set to provide further fillip to the ever-growing bilateral cooperation. In case this is
All India Radio giving you the news.
अरे अजय भाई, आपका बेटा राहुल ने दिखाई दिया?
भारद्वाज जी, वो किचन में है, खाना बना रहा है।
किचन में? क्यों, कोमल बेटिया का है?
कोमल बेटी तो बाहर है, कुछ सामान वगैरह वगैरह तो दफ्तर से लेती आएगी।
मतलब बेटी बाहर और बेटा किचन में? अजय जी, ये क्या कर रखा है?
कुछ खास नहीं जी, बेटियों और बेटों को बराबर बना रखा है।
बेटों और बेटियों में फर्क क्या कर लो, बेटियों के पंखों को बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ महिला एवं बाल विकास मंत्रालय द्वारा जल्द मंदिर दरगाह या गुरुद्वारा नहीं छोड़ा था, जहाँ इसकी मन्नत मांगी है। स्टेशन पर खो गई थी, मिली थी तो कैसे, इन पंगियों के निशान से आधार कार्ड बनवाया था इसका। सुना, वो आधार में बच्चों की फिंगरप्रिंट देते हैं ना,
उससे कोई भी खोए हुए बच्चे को अपने घर तक पहुंचा सकता है।
ये तो मैंने सोचा ही नहीं था, तो आप सोच लो।
आधार अपना लो,
External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj has left on a four-day visit to Qatar and Kuwait to boost ties with two partners in West Asia. On the first leg of her visit, Ms. Swaraj will reach Qatar, where she is scheduled to meet the Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Foreign Affairs, Mohammed bin Abdul Rahman bin Jassim Al Thani. She will also call on the Emir of Qatar, Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani. On the second leg, Ms. Swaraj will travel to Kuwait. There she will hold talk with Deputy Prime Minister and Foreign Affairs Minister Sheikh Sabah Al Sabah. Also scheduled to call the Emir of Kuwait, Sheikh Jamir Al Ahmad Al Sabah. The External Affairs Ministry said in a statement that the visit is in pursuit of India's objective of enhanced engagement with the Gulf region, which is in India's extended neighborhood. Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena today charged Mr. Ranil Wickremesinghe, whom he replaced in the Prime Minister's post last week, of being corrupt and tending to take individual decisions. In a recorded message telecast this evening, Mr. Sirisena said he had strong policy differences with Ranil and blamed him for bond scam and poor economic management. He also charged involvement of a cabinet minister in a plot to assassinate him. Mr. Sirisena defended swearing in of Mahinda Rajapakse as Prime Minister, saying it was the only alternative open to him under the existing situation. More from our correspondent.
In a long address, Sri Lankan President charged Mr. Ranil Wickremesinghe of failing to understand the pulse of people and violating the principles of good governance. He asserted that fighting decision to appoint Mahinda Rajapakse as Prime Minister was far more challenging and risky than the decision he took in November 2014 for contesting against Mr. Rajapakse. Meanwhile, political turmoil continued and one person was killed when a mysterious bodyguard fired at a mob loyal to President's party. Mr. Wickremesinghe has refused to vacate his official residence, and this party is planning to organize a mass protest next week. Santosh Kumar for AIR News from Colombo.
BJP today hit out at Congress leader Shashi Tharoor over his derogatory remarks on Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Talking to reporters in New Delhi, party leader and Union Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad asked Congress Chief Rahul Gandhi to clarify if it supported Mr. Tharoor's comments. He said the Congress claims to represent the heritage of Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru and Indira Gandhi, and today, under the leadership of Rahul Gandhi, the opposition party has been reduced to hurling abuses and the worst form of civil discourse. In Maharashtra, the state government has opened a number of Jan Aushadhi outlets in order to provide quality medicines at affordable price to the masses under the Pradhan Mantri Jan Aushadhi Yojana. These outlets have helped patients to save their money significantly. Here is a ground report from our Aurangabad correspondent.
In order to impart the benefits of concessional medicines to general public under the Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Yojana, the purpose of the government is to introduce the speedy outlets and generic drugs in the market. Sanjay Saraf, a resident from Aurangabad city who is suffering from high blood pressure and sugar ailment, said that unlike earlier, he is now saving money after purchasing these generic medicines.
मुझे बीपी और शुगर है, इसलिए मैं जनरली की गोले लेता हूँ। पहले जो मैडम ने मिट्टी दिया था वो ले रखा, कोई फर्क नहीं है, लेकिन जनरली की गोली बहुत सस्ती है। पहले मुझे 1300-1400 रुपए खर्चा आता था मैं मंथली, अब मेरे को 550-600 रुपए के अंदर मेरा पूरा महीने का छोटा कम्प्लीट हो गया।
ड्यू टू दिस जेनरिक ड्रग्स कस्टमर्स आर सेविंग अप टू 70% अमाउंट एज कम्पेयर टू द ब्रांडेड मेडिसिन। रमेश जायवायर न्यूज औरंगाबाद।
For quick news updates on the clock, follow us on our Twitter handle at AIR News Alert. You can also log on to our website, newsonair.nic.in.
कुछ रोग किसी को भी हो सकता है, चाहे वह किसी भी धार्मिक, लिंग, सामाजिक, आर्थिक स्तर का हो। इसका संपूर्ण इलाज उपलब्ध है। कुछ रोगी के हाथ, पैर और चेहरे पर आई विकृतियों को ऑपरेशन द्वारा ठीक किया जा सकता है।
पूज्य कुष्ठ प्रभाग स्वास्थ्य सेवा महानिदेशालय भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी।
जन्म से लेकर 5 साल तक की उम्र के बच्चों को 7 बार टीकाकरण के लिए लेकर जाना। 7 बार में से 1 व्यक्ति उठना नहीं चाहिए, ये जिम्मेदारी हम सबकी है। जो दूसरे टीके भूल जाते हैं ना, ये देखिए अच्छी बात नहीं है। सारे चीज को समय से लगेंगे तभी जानलेवा बीमारियों से बच्चों को सुरक्षा मिले। 5 साल 7 बार छूटना टीका एक भी बार। स्वास्थ्य एवं परिवार कल्याण मंत्रालय जनहित में जारी।
The Supreme Court is likely to hear tomorrow a batch of pleas challenging the Allahabad High Court's 2010 verdict by which the disputed land on the Ram Janmabhoomi Babri Masjid area in Ayodhya was divided into 3 parts. A bench of Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi, Justice Sanjay Kishan Kaul and K.M. Joseph would hear the appeals filed in the matter. Delhi recorded very poor air quality today as a thick haze engulfed the national capital, which continues to grapple with deteriorating air quality. According to CCTV, the overall air quality index of the national capital was recorded at 360, which falls in the very poor category. The News Services Division awarded the Living Weekly Bilingual Lifeline Program, Public Speak Tomorrow, will bring you a discussion on 21st Century India and Vallabhbhai Patel. This can be heard on FM Gold Channel, frequencies from 9:30 p.m. In hockey, defending champions India will take on arch rivals Pakistan in the final of the Asian Champions Trophy in Muscat, Oman tonight. The match will begin at 10:40 p.m. After securing a 3-1 victory over Pakistan early in the tournament, India will look forward to continue its dominance. In cricket, the 4th ODI between India and the West Indies will be played in Mumbai tomorrow. The match will begin at 1:30 p.m. The series is tied at 1-1 with 2 matches to go. And now, before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Prime Minister Narendra Modi stresses on collective efforts to tackle problems of terrorism and climate change, along with economic development. In his Mann Ki Baat program, Mr. Modi commends role of tribal communities in preserving natural resources, emphasizes an adoption of balanced lifestyle for environment protection. India-Japan summit will be held in Tokyo tomorrow. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj leaves on a 4-day visit to Qatar and Kuwait to enhance India's engagement in the Gulf region. And in hockey, defending champions India to take on Pakistan in the Asian Champions Trophy final in Muscat tonight. And that is all in the news at 9. Good night.